Hello Dreamers, how are you doing? So many people ask me this question, if they can apply the Canadian PR through the express entry process without their spouse. Now, why do they ask this? What are the benefits? What are the disadvantages? I'll tell you in this video. Stay tuned. Hello everybody, I am Shitanshu from Dream Abroad. I regularly upload Canadian immigration and lifestyle videos, so if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, please click the subscribe button and press the bell icon so that you don't miss any of my videos. And now you can follow me on Instagram as well. My Insta handle is dreamabroad.mylife. Spouse not accompanying. What does this mean? So if you are a couple, a husband or a wife, and either of you is the primary applicant, there's a chance that you don't want the spouse to accompany you to Canada as the permanent resident. Now, why is this question arising? It's not because of the distance in the relationship, it's because of a very technical reason. I'll tell you right now. So, you know that express entry, there are a certain number of points. So, if you take a special note of it, you'll see that the points awarded to the age factor, to the level of education, the language proficiency, and the Canadian work experience. If you are a single guy, in that case, you'll score more points. Do you see the grid on your right-hand side? You'll score 110 points, the maximum score, if you are single. Not single, actually, if you're applying the PR alone, which means that either you're single or you're applying the PR without your spouse. Similarly, in other factors as well, you'll score more points, 10 points more than what you would score if you were actually applying the PR with your spouse. So why is this discrimination? This is not a discrimination. This is because of the other points table. So if you look at the other points table, these spousal factors. So in this grid, you'll notice that similar number of points have been given to spousal factors. So if your spouse has got a good education, like a master's, a PhD degree, you'll get 10 points. If your spouse can score CLB 9 or more, you'd get 20 points, similarly for the Canadian work experience. So this is the reason why they actually give lesser points to the people who are actually married and who are applying the Canadian PR with their spouse. So that when their points add up with their spouses, they are at par with those guys who are not applying with their spouse. I hope the concept is clear. Which brings me to the point of this video. So if you are a married person, and your score is, let's say, around 450. If he or she doesn't have a good degree, like just a normal diploma or not even that, in that case, you would score lesser number of points if you apply the PR with your spouse. So just for an example, let's say that you are actually applying the PR without your spouse. In that case, your score is something around 450. And if you're applying the PR with your spouse, in that case, your score is something around 430. So of course it is beneficial for you to apply the PR without the spouse so that at least you can get the PR, and after that when you reach Canada you can actually sponsor your spouse to become the permanent resident of Canada. But of course you cannot say this to the immigration officer in your profile. When you actually create your profile, if they ask you that is your spouse accompanying you, if you say no, in that case they would definitely ask for a reason. Now, this reason which you have to give is very important, of course. You need not provide a documentary proof of that reason, but yes, you have to get a legitimate reason to convince the officer that your spouse is not accompanying you for that particular reason. Now, what can that reason be? There can be many reasons, actually, depending from one person to the other, one family to the other. Just like if your spouse is working somewhere, you can say that your spouse is not willing to give up her career at this moment. Maybe her job is doing really good and she's going to get a promotion very soon. So she's not willing to give up her job at this stage of her life. I mean, supposing that the primary applicant is the husband. So if, just in case your wife is pregnant, in that case, you can say that your wife is not accompanying you because she's pregnant. You don't want her to travel in that conditions. You don't want your child to be born in very cold conditions. So, I mean, these are all the reasons. Let's say if your kid is very small, you can say that, you know, your kid is not that adaptive to different weather conditions. So that is the reason you don't want your spouse to travel with you, and you'll be traveling alone. Once your kid is like 2, 3 years of age, they both will be traveling to Canada with you. Suppose you have two kids, and of course, because you'll be traveling to Canada, you'll be searching a job over there. So you can say that I have two kids over here. My wife will be taking care of them once I get the job. Then after that, I'll apply for the PR of my kids and my wife, and that means my family. And then after that, they'll be coming over to Canada. So these are all legitimate reasons which you can give actually. But one thing which you should not do at all is you should not lie that you're not married. You should definitely tell the immigration team. You should definitely tell IRCC that you're married. You should definitely furnish your marriage certificate, your child's birth certificate, whatever documents are actually needed. All right, so points to note. So of course you would want your wife or your spouse to come over there into Canada sometime down the line. But there are some certain conditions for that. You can definitely sponsor your spouse for the permanent residence, but there are a few points which you must note before you take this decision. So first of all, you should know that you must be living in Canada if you have to sponsor your spouse for permanent residence. So this is a very important point to note. If you think that you just get a COPR and after that you'll apply for your wife, it's not possible. You have to go there and you must physically be living in Canada. Only after that you can apply for your spouse's PR. The second important point to note is that the maximum processing time is 1 year. So there are a good number of chances that it would take 1 year for your spouse to get the PR. So in that case, you guys would be living apart, in your home country and in Canada that period of time, which is actually a long time. The other point to note is that you should show that you can provide for the basic needs of any persons you're sponsoring. So in this case, your spouse, you should be able to furnish a proof that you're actually working over there. You've got a job, you've got a regular job. Only after that you'll be able to sponsor your spouse for the permanent residence. So these are the points of to apply the spousal PR. But before you apply the spousal PR for your own PR, you actually need to submit your spousal's medical certificate. That's a mandatory document. You also need to submit your spousal's police certificate. And of course, you need to be very cautious with the proof of funds as well, because your spouse is not accompanying you. So in that case, you should be cautious. You should not count that money as proof of funds where your wife is the only account holder. So if you have a joint account, then still fine. But if your wife is the only account holder, in that case, you should not give that account as the proof of funds. The primary account holder should have the account in his or her name, or you can have a joint account as well. So yes, these were some points which needs to be noted. I just hope that the information shared in this video would be helpful to you guys. So thank you for watching this video, guys. I really hope that the information that I've been sharing from the last 1 year is helping you guys. If yes, please comment down below. And also, I noticed that many people don't subscribe. They come to my channel, watch my videos, but they don't subscribe. So please don't forget to press the subscribe button before you move on to the next video. Thanks again for watching this video.